the PBA present the championship round finals of the Rochester Open. And now, a panoramic view of the High Falls Dam, located in Rochester, New York, not far from beautiful Marcel's Olympic Bowl, the site of tonight's Rochester Open. Hi, everybody. I'm Denny Schreiner, along with PBA Hall of Famer Mike Durbin. And, Mike, I have a sneaking suspicion that we may see some Hall of Fame-type performances here tonight in Rochester.
Well, we've got an outstanding cast, Denny. The combined top five tonight have averaged 234 for all their games this week. Our tournament leader has averaged 242. We got the leading candidate for player of the year, plus another challenger. We've got a great cast here.
Many storylines. We'll start from the bottom of the stack, the number five qualifier. It has been 7 years since he last won, and the place that he won his last victory, right here at Marcel's Olympic Bowl. We talk of Tom Baker, one of the hometown favorites.
1986, he beat Steve Wunderlich here. It's been 2 years since he's made a telecast. He's had wrist problems for a number of years since he broke that wrist, but right now he's got a shot where the hand feels relatively comfortable and strong, and it fits this condition. He had to beat Walter Ray in the position round last night to make it in here, so he figures if he can do that, he can do anything.
Last week, Mike and I both kidded with victorious Bryan Goebel, and we said, well, do you think you could win two in a row? He's seriously thinking about repeating because he's qualified number four.
Well, Bryan Goebel said he had always bowled well here at Marcel's Olympic Bowl. He's bowled well all week long. He's carried forward the momentum he had last week. He's got a tough test tonight. You know, if he could win here, though, Denny, it would keep his hopes alive for player of the year because that would give him four victories in time with Norm Duke. But he's got to win four games. That won't be easy tonight.
I know that you will appreciate this next statistic. Pete Weber has won at least one title or more in 10 consecutive years. That's a decade of winning out here. But he has a couple of second place finishes this year. With only three tournaments left to go, he is winless in 94. He would dearly love to step into the winner's circle here tonight.
And he's feeling the pressure. He says he's thinking about that, but he went home last week, worked out with his brother Rich. They worked on a new hand release. He's come out, made that hand release work right here now. And another very interesting thing, he says that winning is very important to him again right now. So look out, he may get victory number 22 here tonight.
After a spectacular winter tour, Norm Duke obviously had to miss a number of tournaments because of a foot injury. He has four victories. He is the leading candidate right now for player of the year. He is slotted in that advantageous number two position. My question to you is, if he wins tonight, does he lock up player of the year?
Well, in my mind, he does, but I don't count. I don't have any vote on the thing. But if he wins tonight, it is victory number five. It really solidifies his hold on. And the interesting thing is that Norm is using a shot here that's different from what we normally see Norm. Norm has been throwing what they call that slow boat all year long, hooking it way out and coming back. Here he's going straighter than anybody else on the telecast, but the ball is still rolling out of the pocket. It shows me the enormous talent that he has. He can hook it, throw it straight. He can do anything with that bowling ball, but we'll see if he can win here tonight.
Our top seed, Doug Kent of nearby Canandaigua, New York. All he did last night was average 260 and win all eight matches. But all he did all week long, Mike Durbin, was just lead this thing from start to finish. He is 0-2 from the top seed position. He has never won on the PBA Tour. With fans and friends alike watching here tonight, the heat is really going to be on.
The heat will be on, but he averaged 242 all week long. He averaged 246 on this pair. He is an ABC Masters champion, so he knows what it's like to win a championship match. This is probably his best opportunity because he does have the support of his fans and family. Maybe they can carry him on to victory.
Earlier this summer, Butch Soper shot 300 on national television on ESPN. It was the eighth 300 game in the history of the PBA. With the looks of the conditions here this evening, we could see some strings of strikes. And we're ready now to start our opening match featuring Bryan Goebel, who won last week, and Tommy Baker, who would love another victory. To say that this bunch watching here tonight is revved up would be an understatement.
Well, they've been watching the guys bowl in practice all for the last hour or so, and they've been doing nothing but strike. So everybody is hyped up and anticipating, as you said, strings of strikes and big scores.
Baker comes out, light hit, and leaves the soft seven on lane 33.
Everybody said the pair played pretty much the same. The PBA this week is oiling 28 feet, carrying the oil forward, dragging it down to 45 feet with a spray gun only and what they call a Christmas tree pattern.
Saving the wood, Tommy Baker with a spare in the first. Now the man who is looking to win a back-to-back, Bryan Goebel.
Now, for Bryan, he's got the right lane hooking more for him than the left lane. Interesting, you know, Doug Kent hit it the X opposite way around, so it's different roles. See that ball just roll out right at the pocket? All the players are doing that. Bryan Goebel, six-step player, holds that ball high right up here as he starts. Pushes it out with that nice long arm. Watch as he gets to the peak of the backswing, right about in here, and you see it go right up like so. Nice long slide, good balance, good follow through. Left arm out there for balance, trying for the double.
Shakes him up, favorable bounce, and he starts with a double.
Where Baker didn't get that seven pin out, he did. Tommy a little nervous, first time on TV in a couple of years, and he knows he's got the ability to make better shots than he has in the last couple of frames here. Just needs to relax, gain a little confidence. Very well. Wow.
Wow.
Tommy Baker, five-step player, again holds the ball right up here. Steps. Now he's kind of just pushes it down, head and shoulders go forward a little bit. See right here, nice shoulder-high backswing. Nice long slide. Good finish. And right now he's having trouble getting 10.
Won 7 of 8 matches last night. Averaged 250 en route to making the telecast.
Came from a long way back.
I don't think there's any question that after 2 years of not appearing in the championship round, he is a touch nervous here tonight.
Well, he's going to be a touch behind, too, if Goebel gets up here and throws two more strikes. He's already 23 behind. He could be 43 after a couple more frames here.
Player right now bowling with as much confidence on the PBA Tour as any player out here.
And his hand release is just so pretty. Ooh, a solid nine. You know, it's interesting, Dan. I was talking to him earlier, and he used to loft the ball way out on the lane. And now he sets it down much smoother. But he was making his adjustments this week, not by moving his feet so much, but by the loft on the ball. He would loft it a little bit more when they started to hook and just adjust that way. And I never possessed that kind of ability. I wasn't in with my repertoire to just change, going it further out of the lane and setting it down shorter to make that adjustment that way. But that's what he did this week.
Obviously delaying the roll a little bit the further you send it out.
Right. Right. He would do that, you know, further out as they started hooking more and set it down earlier when they were tighter. And to him, he can set it down earlier on this left lane because it's a little tighter for him.
Flush hit in the fourth. And Bryan Goebel with an early 22-pin lead in the Greater Rochester Open. We'll be back with more from Marcel's Olympic Bowl right after these messages.
And now, a simple demonstration of what gives AMF's new King Cobra its powerful combination of hook and control. To create the King Cobra, we adapted the core technology of our immensely successful Cobra ball and added our new Strike R reactive resin. A little more. More. Come on now, don't be shy with it. That's more like it. The new King Cobra from AMF, with more reactive resin than we've ever put in a bowling ball.
Science is best done in an interactive environment. You have to have this incredible curiosity, and you have to figure out how it works. You're not learning something that someone else has written down. You get to discover that. And the best time for a scientist is when you get a result that is exactly the opposite of what you thought was going to happen. Because in that brief moment of time, the whole world changes.
Glaxo, on the brink of discovery.
It's everybody working together that's going to beat the disease.
The championship round finals of the Rochester Open are being brought to you by AMF Bowling, makers of the new King Cobra ball with Strike R resin. Tommy Baker down by 22 and looking to make something positive happen here.
I think he's going to turn it around right now.
See, Tom, it's not that tough.
He's got to put it together, though, now. He strikes here. He's down 12 pins, right back in the match.
Tommy with 7 career titles. As we mentioned, last victory, 1986.
Blow that air out here, then. Speed was a little soft and you threw it too far right, it would overreact and go high. But all week long, and I threw some shots in practice when we were doing the average builder, you know, you could stand left and throw it right and it'd come back forever.
So there is unlimited room to the right. You just don't want to set it short.
Yeah. Now this time he just switched balls at the spare and he made it. You know, that shows me he didn't throw practice at the 3-6 in the hour of practice that he had.
Well, I threw so many strikes, why would you worry about spares?
Well, they're part of the game. Again, the little high on the right lane. He's got it hooking more for him. You know, I would think that he'd just move another board or so left. Bryan Goebel, high backswing, clean release. See how light he stayed behind and how those fingers just rotated right up through the ball? Beautiful shot there.
Spare up for Goebel, who continues to lead by 22. I had a chance to chat with him last night and ask him about his entire game coming together.
I've worked so hard to make my game solid and competitive and smooth, and I feel like everything is feeling like it should be right there in place, and that makes it a lot easier to keep my concentration focused on what I'm doing. It makes it easier to do nothing but throw the ball where you want to throw it and not worry too much about anything else.
Right now, the only thing he's worried about is carrying 10 pins on the right lane. He keeps 9 pin and a 4 pin. Keeps Baker in the match.
The 9 pin was a great shot.
Well, the 4 pin was a good shot, too. Just hooked a hair early. Wow. 3 shots through the nose. Tommy didn't throw 3 shots through the nose in an hour of practice.
No, not even close. It's got to be nerves.
Yeah, it does. Just needs a little more extension, a little more reach with that shot. Kind of like he did there with the spare.
Almost looks like right now he's just trying to get the ball off his hand. You know, it's not the kind of shot that he is capable of making.
There's Bianca, Tommy's daughter. One of them.
Mm-hmm.
There's another one.
10 years old.
Tugging on her ear there. She's got some sign going on with somebody.
Maybe it's a good luck sign.
Well, it needs it. Gave that one more room and it rolled out at the pocket.
Better start tugging on both ears.
Yeah, right.
24-pin lead for Bryan Goebel, who could really apply the pressure if he throws a couple more strikes. We're in the opening match of the Greater Rochester Open, live from Marcel's Olympic Bowl. We'll be back with more right after this.
The best test of yourself is to team up with others. There's something about pulling together that helps you do better on your own. Maybe it's because your effort helps somebody else. Maybe it's because it's not necessarily over just because you have a bad night. Or maybe it's because you never stand taller than when you stand together. League bowling at BPAA Center. It's a whole lot more than a game.
Clearview Lanes in Mount Joy.
The Lilac City Tournament paid out over $1 million in prize money last year.
Bowl, have fun, and win big money in Rochester, New York.
Enter the High Fang Men's Team Event.
The Women's Team Event.
And the Mixed Team Event.
Win with the Lilac. 18 great events, including doubles and singles for men, women, and mixed.
We plan to pay over $1 million in prize money again.
Call 1-800-36-LILAC now.
Win with Lilac.
All right, we mentioned 10th year in Rochester here at Marcel's. Let's take a look back at some of the past champions.
And our opening one, the great Marshall Holman. Of course, Tom Baker is on tonight's telecast. Scott Devers, a very talented left-hander. Ron Palumbi Jr. in 88. Joe Berardi, a fastballer there. Mm-hmm. Roger Bowker, won here a couple of times, I think. Yeah, 93, he won also. David Ozio, his big year in 91 when he was player of the year.
And so was McDowell, player of the year in 92.
Right.
And this guy right here is thinking about player of the year in 94, but a lot of work left.
See if he can make the adjustment that he needs. See if he gets any more loft on it here, Dan. Get that thing a little bit further down the lane. Nope, he's consistent. I'll tell you, 9-pin, 4-pin, 4-pin, all right in about the same spot, you know? And he's shaking his head. I got to move here.
When you leave a 4-pin, are you a half a board high?
Generally, that's what my move always was, a half a board.
So far, every ball in the pocket for Bryan Goebel, but he's been really unable to shake Tom Baker.
You said that we were talking in the break there that if he doesn't distance himself pretty quick, you know, Tommy's going to figure it out and get back in this match. We see the score right there, difference 24 pins. Baker on that strike, the 8th and 9th frames coming up.
Bakes has had lots of problems, though, with the right-hand lane.
He's got one strike. He's had problems putting two good shots in a row.
Well, there's no question the ball holds pocket better on 33.
Well, he's got it rolling out right dead flush every time over on that one.
Still room for 225 for Tom Baker of Buffalo, New York.
He's going to do it, then. He's got to do it now.
Threw some great shots in the clutch last night against Walter Rigg. And his fiance looking on, no smile yet. Almost one.
She knew she was on TV, though, so. She'll smile even bigger if he gets one more here.
I hear
you. This cuts the lead down to 4 pins and sets him up for the 10th frame. Like you say, he threw some great clutch shots last night against Walter Ray. Just like that.
Well, his dad, Hank, kind of reserved at this point. Of course, he knows Tommy will come through in the clutch. He has so many times before. Changes the complexity of this match, though.
If he doesn't strike right now, he can be, no matter what he does, Baker can win. Moved in a little bit. It went real high that time. He just hasn't been able to make the adjustment on that right lane. Tremendous break there, only leaving the 6-pin. If you give him this spare now, strike him out in the 10th frame, he finishes with 219. Baker, like we said, can go up for 225.
This would be a major comeback win for Tom Baker if he ends up advancing into the next game. It looked like Goebel had him right by the throat and was ready to just move on into game number two.
Goebel wants to sneak by this match and then try another adjustment on the right lane on lane 34. He knows he can hit that lane. He just hasn't quite figured it out.
Three strikes here gives him 219. He forces Baker to at least double.
Right. Smooth. Dices him up right there. He's perfect on the left lane. You know, you break the game down. You get 7 shots if you strike out in the 10th frame on one lane and 5 on the other. He could wind up with 7 strikes on this left lane.
And watching his demeanor, body language right now, it's very much business as usual. Let's just get this next one, then we force Tommy to double.
But in the back of his mind, he knows that he's possibly let this one slip away. For the double. Oh, the solid 10. He went straighter with that one, Dan. didn't arc like the other ones. So he's going to finish with 209. Baker just needs the first one.
Just needs the first one.
Just needs the first one. I fully expect him to get it.
Easier said than done.
Not for Tommy.
Okay.
He always struck against me.
Well, he knew what he was up against.
Well, yeah, easy.
He was always very confident when bowling Herr Durbin. All right.
Just couldn't get comfortable. Bryan knows that he escaped something that maybe he shouldn't have here. We never thought a 2-0 game would win here tonight.
Not in a million years. The truth be known, I think Tommy would tell you, I did not perform at all like I was hoping.
No. I think he hit four shots through the nose. He left the 3-6 here three times. Missed it once. That ultimately turned out to be the difference in the match, that missed spare.
For Tom Baker, a fifth-place finish, but if the truth be known, Bakes was probably thrilled to death that he had a chance in the 10th frame to win this match.
Oh, yeah. He had it there. I mean, to only need one strike to win the match, you know, you can't ask for much more than that.
This will strike. Tom made the big adjustment left. Ball rolled early and hooked early for him every time on the right-hand lane.
Good for Bryan Goebel, too.
You're right. All right, Bryan Goebel, still with thoughts of repeating here in Rochester as he'll advance on to game number two with a 209-200 victory over Tom Baker.
If you had nothing to hold you back, how would you design the world's most advanced bowling ball? You'd probably pick the best brains in the business, cutting-edge computer design tools, the hottest resins and manufacturing technologies. You'd probably try to change the structure of the game forever. But don't bother. We've already done it. Hurry. Make the quantum leap.
Science is best done in an interactive environment. You have to have this incredible curiosity and you have to figure out how it works. You're not learning something that someone else has written down. You get to discover that. And the best time for a scientist is when you get a result that is exactly the opposite of what you thought was going to happen. Because in that brief moment of time, the whole world changes.
Glaxo, on the brink of discovery.
It's everybody working together that's going to beat the disease.
Excuse me. I'm looking for some new shoes to replace these.
The Sports Authority has athletic footwear.
So, what you got?
Well, we've got running shoes, walking shoes.
All your favorite brand names for every sport imaginable. Even if it's not sports you're looking for.
Even inline skates, casual shoes, hiking shoes, cross-country.
And everyday low prices mean you never wait for a sale.
Now these feel great.
What do you want me to do with these?
Burn them.
The Sports Authority. You've never seen anything quite like it.
Hope it still works.
What are you supposed to do?
We need to have an extensive knowledge on offensive and defensive football strategies.
Do they move?
They move.
Show them to me.
Want some real excitement? Order ABC College Football Games on pay-per-view in addition to the game on your local ABC station. Check Friday's sports section of USA Today for games available in your area or call your local cable company today.
I thought we were going to watch real football.
For this week's Average Builder, we were going to talk about how we could measure the speed of our bowling ball. But if all of our equipment is not working like we'd like it to, so we're going to talk about another item of speed, mainly the approach speed. Or in other words, how can I stop charging the foul line, especially on key shots? Many people have that problem that they simply go to the foul line too fast. It may be because of their personality, they're just aggressive people, and it may be that they simply have quick feet. In any case, they get to the line too fast and the shot becomes an errant shot, going either left or right. Well, here's a couple of thoughts that you can think of, especially on key shots, that'll help control that. On your first step, what we like to think about, what I think about, is heel-toeing that first step, just like so. The heel goes down first, and then the ball of the foot rolls in. What this does is it gets me off on a smooth, controlled start. I'm not just rushing up there that way.
And the other thing that I like to think about is on my next to last step, and with me it's my third step, I want to also heel-toe that step. When I'm right in this position, the heel comes down first and then the toe. What this does is if I have gone up a little too quickly, I can catch up here and still get in position to make a good shot and have a good finish. Now, earlier I threw a shot. Let's take a look at the first step and the third step and see if the heel goes down first. There's the start, the ball pushes, the step goes at the same time, and the heel goes down. I'm in control right there, not charging to the foul line. As we continue on, I also heel-toe the second step by nature, but as I hit the third step, the heel goes down first, catching me up, putting me in position for a nice long slide and a good follow-through and a good finish. So remember, to cure the problem of charging that foul line, heel-toe the first step and the next to the last step. We're going to Grand Rapids, Michigan next week. Be sure and join us there for another Average Builder.
Up next, a couple of boys from the heartlands of the USA. Weber from St. Ann, Missouri. Bryan Goebel from Marion, Kansas. And Lil Bull here in Rochester, New York, when we come back.
Whoever said, now is the winter of our discontent, never stood behind our windows. Owens Corning. We make the difference. This evacuation vehicle is not protected by a 70,000-mile warranty. It's protected by a glass fiber that's stronger than steel. Owens Corning. We make the difference.
Sports fans, you've seen the best. Now, Marv Albert's here to show you the rest.
Lots of horsing around in the world of sports.
There's 45 minutes of non-stop fun in Marv's great new video, the hilarious Albert Achievement Award. And best of all, your video's free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated. In this great new video, Marv captures all the amazing footwork, agility, grace, and power that makes sports so much fun to watch.
Hysterical!
Call now and you'll also get your choice of an authentic NFL Pro-Line hat. Free! Pick your favorite team. It's up to you. The Albert Achievement Awards video and the NFL hat of your choice make a great gift for yourself or your favorite sports fan. And it comes with 54 issues of Sports Illustrated for only $1.47 an issue. You save over 50% off the cover price. For quicker delivery, use your credit card. Nobody's into sports like Sports Illustrated. Get into it.
Record crowds all week long in Rochester watching the professionals perform for the 10th consecutive year at Marcel's Olympic Bowl. Bryan Goebel, Pete Weber. Get ready.
I look for better things out of Goebel this game, and I look for big things out of Pete. This new hand release is really working well. Right back to that four pin again. Now you hit the right lane. This game, leave four pins on the left lane. That's the way this game goes.
In your educated opinion, is it time for a ball change?
No. I was surprised how he's playing the lanes anyway, Dan. I thought he would be standing further left and trying to arc the ball more. That seems to be a good shot for him, but he's had success doing what he's been doing all week long, so he knows his game. And the cries of Pete, Pete, Pete.
Chants have already started. A number of the faithful have already picked him to win this.
Way left. Send it way out.
And watch it come back.
And away go the pins.
Is that a haymaker?
Some kind of maker, I'll tell you. Pete Weber standing at the back of the approach back here. Five-step player. Head is very steady. A tremendously high backswing as he gets right into here, way up there. The drive and all that leverage. Look at the straight line there. Left arm out there.
Needs a little help. Didn't get the job done. Soft 10 on lane 33.
You know, I don't know that it was so much that he liked the left lane that much. That he wanted to make Goebel finish on the lane he had all the trouble with.
Which which was lane 34.
Right.
Smart for Pete, used one of his practice balls just prior to this match to shoot a 10-pin.
Well, it cost Tommy Baker when he didn't know what the ball was going to do at the 3-6. Goebel kind of points his feet to the left, walks a little bit that way.
All right, he's made the adjustment there. Let's see what he does on 33. With Bryan Goebel, with Norm Duke, and Walter Ray just missing this week, we thought it might be a good time to update our fans around the country on that Bowler of the Year race.
And you see the money standings right here. Duke really way out in front. There are the titles on the left. Duke with four, of course, Goebel with three. Money, Goebel's almost 100,000 behind. You wouldn't think he has a chance, but you never know. Players look at a lot of different categories, not just money.
More room. Here comes the next. Well, throughout tonight's telecast, we're going to show the bowling fans a number of the other statistical categories that the players all look at when they decide to cast their votes.
And the players are very analytical when they make that choice. They evaluate a lot of different things. You know, they evaluate high average, they evaluate money, they evaluate titles, they evaluate match play appearances, championship round appearances, a lot of different things.
Is looking sweet, and I had an opportunity to chat with Pete last night and ask him, what did you do when you went home to work on your game and come back and bowl well?
I worked on it for 5 days, and I came out. I really didn't expect to do very well this week. I was just out here to practice the release and make sure it was going all right, and here I am. Look out. I've had a little fire in my eye this week, and I'm feeling real good.
What he's trying to do is stay behind that ball longer. Boy, the soft 10 and now the 4-7. And get the ball rolling a little bit more forward as it enters the pins. Watch him as he comes through here. See how he's way behind the ball. He goes around, but you see the fingers lift straight through it. It's kind of like Amleto, a little bit like Amleto. That's his release go. That even though it's covering all those boards, the ball's rolling forward as it goes into the pins, and a lot of people feel that that makes the pins carry better.
Right, just trying to stay behind the ball longer to get a little more leverage and get a little more end-over-end roll.
But with the fingers on. I mean, the hand starts to go around the ball, but the fingers lift up the back. It's really an interesting, but he's doing very well here. He feels that Goebel does this naturally. What he does is just business-like work.
There is no doubt in my mind that he realizes that he escaped with his life in match number one.
Now watch Bryan. See, both of them, that tremendously high backswing to generate that leverage, that long arm. Now watch, he's behind the ball, and you see the fingers snap up there. He starts to go around the side, but the fingers snap up behind the ball. It's really interesting.
Those are world-class releases.
And the leverage both of them get with that high backswing and long arm.
Looking for a four-bagger. Bingo.
Bingo, bango.
Bongo comes in the sixth.
Yeah, right.
The heat Weber is on very quickly against Mr. Weber.
And Peter, you know, looking for that victory to keep that 10-year streak going. Boy, he's got to figure out how to hit the left lane real quick.
Down by 30 pins.
Somebody moving. Oh, yeah. The cameraman had his camera out from behind the screen there. Somebody's out on the side there, in fact. That's the screen that the camera people, photographers, are behind. Those little holes there, they stick their cameras through and pop the shots. And no trouble with the right lane.
Boy, if you're enjoying the action here this evening, don't forget next week from the Welsh Auditorium, we'll bring you the finals of the Great Lakes PBA Classic, 7:30 next Wednesday night, Eastern Time, live on ESPN. We're going to go back to the auditorium next week, and that should be a lot of fun. Great bowling fans in Grand Rapids.
Pete Weber's made 70 telecasts, and he needs to draw upon that experience right now to put two strikes in a row together.
High the last time. Another 10-pin.
See, he made the adjustment for the first 10-pin, then went high, moved back. The ball is rolling out right at the pocket, but rolling out for the weak 10 instead of rolling out flush.
And we'll just roll on out here for a commercial break. Pete Weber down by 30, but don't ever ever count this guy out. We'll be back with more after this.
Science is best done in an interactive environment. You have to have this incredible curiosity and have to figure out how it works. You're not learning something that someone else has written down. You get to discover that. And the best time for a scientist, when you get a result that is exactly the opposite of what you thought was going to happen. Because in that brief moment of time, the whole world changes.
Glaxo, on the brink of discovery.
It's everybody working together that's going to beat the disease.
Right now during Sears Days, all Craftsman hand tools and all power tools are on sale. All paint, every gallon, every brand is on sale. And there's a lot more. The Sears Days sale, bringing America's best to you.
Buy three packs of Polaroid Instant Film between now and December 31st, and we guarantee you a great holiday. And on top of that, we'll give you back $5. See your local retailer for details.
Tonight at 9 Eastern, Anthony Stevens and James Hughes battle for the welterweight championship. Top Rank Boxing on ESPN.
After a solid four-pin in the first, four consecutive strikes, and now a 30-pin lead.
And again, he's in the position that he can really distance himself from Pete Weber right here.
He's figured it out, Dan. He got away with his life in that opening match, and right now he's zeroed in, and Pete Weber knows it.
Give a guy like that a second chance, he'll normally take advantage of it.
And again, just like last week, in the telecast last week, I mean, he's just so confident. Everything about him, his body English, the way he picks up the ball, his look in his eye, he's just not afraid at all. Just knows he can get it done. Oh, and he gets a break there with the four pin.
That's what Pete's thinking. Oh, sure. Left it all along, and now against me, he kicks it out.
Yeah, that's probably exactly what he's thinking. Watch the two pin, third from the left. It goes, and the bottom of the two pin gets the four. Ball was definitely high, but it's an X. Pete, no trouble on the right lane.
Well, if he could stay there, he X's all night long.
Well, he's bullying the proverbial Dutchman right at this point.
Key question. Soft 10, through the nose, back to the 10-pin. What's he do now?
He's got to stick with the 10-pin, try and maybe throw it a little bit harder or a little bit further right to have it roll up flush in the pocket.
Impossible as Kim looks on.
Better late than never.
Yeah, well, maybe. But.
And it is late.
Yeah, it is.
The lights are just about out. They're dimming.
He can get 240 if he goes out. Goebel going at a 240 pace already. Good speed. Well, he crept high. Leaves just the four pin. Could have been worse. Could have been worse. It was pretty high. He got it right a little bit early, right there. It just didn't roll out of the pocket. Kept going.
Revved it up a little bit.
Well, you get it right early. Getting right early. Even with good speed, it'll go high.
Mike and I both want to send out our condolences to the family and friends of Ella O'Quinn, longtime bowling writer and publisher of The Kegler down in San Antonio, Texas. Really a wonderful lady who gave her entire life to the sport of bowling. She passed away this past weekend at the age of 65. And Ella, I know you're up there watching somewhere.
Leaves the 10 pin. Not unhappy with that.
Into the oil early that time.
Just a little bit. It's kind of way out in front and just protecting your lead a little bit. He makes the spare. He's still in the 240s. He forces Weber to strike out to make him mark.
I don't know about protecting a lead against Peter.
Well, sometimes it just happens without even, you're not trying to do it. Mm-hmm. It just kind of happens. It's like any basketball team get way out ahead or something. You know the other team's going to make a run at you.
Sure.
Weber, who hasn't missed this right lane. In fact, everyone's been dead perfect flush. And 49. That's a lot of games, Denny.
Fantastic record. Aggressive shot. Hung it a little bit. Does he get a break? No. And just when everybody thought he would strike on 34, comes up with a 7 pin.
Well, you know, a game can be over in a hurry, especially when the other guy's throwing 6 in a row at you. It just beat her out of the match now at the 7 pin. No chance. That's you get. It's 219.
All you could see was a wry smile from Peter when he didn't strike in the ninth. Did nothing but basically hit the pocket the entire game and finished up with a double. In the seventh and the eighth, that was it. Filling out the frames, it'll be a fourth place finish for Pete Weber. Meanwhile, the man who's thinking repeat comes up with another win.
And now we get a match between two of the contenders for Player of the Year right now. And both of them are thinking about it, Dan.
The guy who's watching right now who would really like to be involved in this is Walter Ray Williams, Jr. He bowled a wonderful game in the position round last night. Just could not carry, and Tommy Baker just eased it on by and solidified the number five position.
Walter Ray got right to the 10th frame and left a hard 10, the first ball in the 10th. That could have really put some pressure on Tommy Baker. Baker needed a mark as it was. He got the strike. He's ready, Dennis.
Ready, willing, and waiting for that man, the leading candidate for PBA Player of the Year, Norm Duke. They'll be matched up next in Rochester after this.
The record, we never broke up. We just took a 14-year vacation. Some old friends are getting together.
Welcome to the Hotel California.
For a memorable concert event. Vacation's over. Plug in.
When a few feel good. The area's best selection with no hassle. Because one low price will get the car you want.
The 95 Voyager at only $16,800. Hurry in before it's too late. This great deal won't last long, so get yours now.
Brubaker's Chrysler Plymouth on the Plymouth Pike in Lancaster. The feel-good, no-hassle, one-low-price dealer.
Mark it down on your calendar. Next Wednesday night, 7:30 sharp, 4:30 on the West Coast. The championship round finals of the Great Lakes PBA Classic from the Welsh Auditorium in Grand Rapids, Michigan. And surveying the rest of the top 24, Walter A. Williams, the newly elected president of the PBA, will take office in January. He was sixth, Mike Albee a close seventh, and Jess Stayrook continues to bowl well. He finished eighth.
Ninth position was Mark Williams, Dave D'Entremont in 10th, and Steve Charles from Bolingbrook, Illinois. Earned $1,900 for 11.
Outstanding. Top 24, Ron Williams was 12th. Billy Oakes, a solid 13th. And Andy Nyer was 14th this week.
15th, Ed Richardson from Corpus Christi. Jeff Gurman, saw him before earlier this year. And Pete Maybank from Sheboygan, Michigan.
Looking on down the rest of the top 24, Butch Soper in the 18th position. Hard striking Jeff Lizzie in the 19th spot. And Parker Bone the third continuing his outstanding play.
21st, Don Mosier, we saw him earlier. George Branham in 22nd, and a voice or name from the past, John Gant, coming back in 23rd.
That's right, old Hacksaw back out to play. Former PBA president Mark McDowell, 24th, and the alternate this week, Hall of Famer Wayne Webb. All right, get out the ballots, because two guys that are in the PBA Player of the Year hunt are heating up here in Rochester.
We're like boys. You're unbelievable.
Like ballet with a boom.
Be the ball.
I like the action. It's action.
Hey, pins, you're dust.
Be the ball.
It's all in the beard.
The grip.
The approach.
Mine. The shoe.
You're unbelievable.
Somebody.
You're unbelievable.
Your frame.
I am the ball.
Who loves your ball?
You're unbelievable.
Science is best done in an interactive environment. You have to have this incredible curiosity and have to figure out how it works. You're not learning something that someone else has written down. You get to discover that. And the best time for a scientist is when you get a result that is exactly the opposite of what you thought was going to happen. Because in that brief moment of time, the whole world changes.
Glaxo, on the brink of discovery.
It's everybody working together that's going to beat the disease.
Polaroid asked me, Sinbad needs supermodels to demonstrate the sleek, stylish Captiva camera. It holds the pictures inside the camera's special pocket till you take them out and put them in your pocket. My pocket. The Polaroid Captiva.
Don't miss Goodyear's big tire sale and 25% savings on four of our most popular radials for passenger cars and light trucks. But you gotta hurry. The big tire sale ends November 5th at participating Goodyear retailers.
Historically, whenever you had a problem in your neighborhood, there was always someone to help you, just when you needed them most. Today, you can still rely on Thrifty for low rates. Use your Montgomery Ward credit card at Montgomery Ward Car Rental at participating Thrifty locations. So whether you're traveling in your neighborhood or to someone else's, we're there. Your neighborhood Thrifty Car Rental, historically known for low rates.
I think one of Stephon's biggest strengths is his court coverage. The way he moves on the court is incredible. If you can get Michael talking a little German out there on the court, you're in pretty good shape.
The Stockholm Open, tomorrow at 1 on ESPN.
All right, Norm Duke finishing up practice shots here. And we mentioned in the open about a right foot problem that he had earlier on. And I asked him, how is it feeling this week in Rochester?
It feels great. My foot hadn't bothered me at all this week for the first time, and I just couldn't feel better about that situation. It's worrisome when you're out here and you're going through the soreness, and it's also has been weighing on me because I just keep wondering how long before I could bowl a tournament that I'm not in so much pain. But this week was wonderful. I went through the whole week and never did anything for it, never thought about it, and so now I'm working on the mental part.
Mental part worked last night. He averaged 253 for the final eight games.
He made that score tonight to beat Bryan Goebel.
Goebel looking for the early quick start.
I was thinking the exact same thing, man. He doesn't want to give Duke room to breathe. He wants to jump on him with both feet right away. And, of course, Duke wants to do the same thing. Duke at the back of the approach. Solid 10 right out of there, going straight as an arrow. Absolutely dead straight.
You mentioned something that was very interesting to me, Mike, after watching all the professionals warm up. You said, you know what? There's a veritable smorgasbord of shots out there. You can pretty much get to the pocket any way that you want.
Which speaks well of the PBA lane maintenance program for this particular bowling center. When you can strike and score like that for a variety of different shots and angles, boy, you know that they've done something right.
I was kidding you and Steve Cross, the PBA lane maintenance director out here, that it's Stevie's smorgasbord tonight. He put the super sauce.
Sweet sauce.
Kind of like barbecue sauce, isn't it? Something like that?
Something like that. I was asking Duke what he thinks about to throw the ball straighter like this than when he tries to hook it. And basically, he's throwing it almost like he does his spare shot, just slightly more powerful than the spare shot that he throws. Like I say, it shows his talent to be able to straighten it out, to hook it, to go straight, to loop it out there. He can do all these things. So can Walter A.
Mm-hmm. That's why you can't shut him out.
That's true. That's why you can't shut him out.
Got
Got it right early. Got it right early, and that's the exact thing he did not want to do against this player. See, he's trying to keep it in closer to the third arrow, and it's out to the eighth board in a hurry and overreact to the notes. He's got to go for this, Dan. I mean, he just can't afford an open against Norm Duke. Oh, and they're going in the right direction, but has the open frame.
For those of you who have never had an opportunity to watch the PBA pros go through a week's work, Michael, you can relate to this.
Lift over 10. Did we lift that much? 10,000 pounds, carry it 2 miles, projecting at 700 times at a speed of 17. Well, mine wasn't that fast.
Right.
But at a target 60 feet away. 42-game tournament. Mm-hmm.
And then you have to come back the next day and try and win it in the championship round. Much better effort there. But Bryan Goebel realizes he's not only opened the door up, he's swung it wide open for Norm Duke.
Right. And Duke, talking about working on the mental, right now is where you show that by taking advantage of an opponent's mistake like that. Nice break. Wasn't his best shot, but he got away with it. Duke, all the way at the back of the approach. See the heels hanging off? Now he'll shuffle those feet just a hair. The right foot goes forward a hair. From then on out, it's five-step approach. Still a long swing. He's forward there, a little higher than shoulder-high backswing. Knees bent right in here, nice angle. Good knee bend here. Finishes up strong. And is carrying everything.
Explodes the rack on 33. He has come rushing back to lead now by 32.
Goebel's got to strike the next two balls or he's going to be out of this match. Ooh, I didn't know whether it was going to hold, but it did. Now he's back to his favorite lane.
One down, one to go. While we've got him hot, ready, and playing here on the lanes, let's go back now to a couple of other stats.
Well, we look at the caches. Walter Ray ahead of Goebel. Duke behind because he took the time off. Top 24s. Again, Walter Ray in the lead. Duke and Goebel tied. Championship rounds. Again, Walter Ray in the lead. The other two pretty close. And we can see Walter Ray is leading in a lot of categories.
No question.
Oh, Bryan Goebel showing his mettle.
Pulling at its best. Boy, back against the wall. Comes up with a key double.
And Duke, who has not really had a solid strike, except for the first one where he left a 10-pin, you know, I think he's still kind of feeling it out.
A little more hand in that shot. Boy, I'll tell you what, that ball is hitting like a ton of bricks. It looks like it's almost moving away from the pocket.
It does, doesn't it?
That looks like an old lacquer shot.
Fall back from 12. Huh?
Sure.
Watch him. Well, it was close to the third arrow. Not much arc. It'll just get the five, but the five goes into the seven in a hurry.
Some positive energy to the five pin. To keep the string alive, a little more velocity, and this time the ball didn't quite get the job done.
You know, these two had a tremendous match in Peoria earlier this year. Norm Duke had set all the scoring records earlier in the week, had bowled two or three 300 games, came out, went strike spare out the sheet for 280 and lost. As Bryan Goebel bowled 296 to win that match. Then a couple weeks later, they bowled each other in New Jersey, and Duke won that match. So this is kind of a rubber match here.
One win apiece. Norm Duke leading by 21, but Goebel is on a three-bagger when we come back to Marcel's Olympic Bowl in Rochester.
Cold sufferers, if your pill's so good, how come it doesn't work 24 hours? Efodac 24 does. Other pills last 6 hours or 12, but one Efodac relieves 24 hours. Efodac keeps cold symptoms from coming back.
Today's engines need Castrol GTX, the motor oil that provides maximum protection against viscosity and thermal breakdown. Because if your oil breaks down, what's next? Castrol GTX, engineered for greater protection against breakdown.
The Sports Authority is the place to go for sportswear.
Look at all this. Isn't this exciting?
Oh, yeah.
There's aerobic wear, sweats, team merchandise.
This could take a while.
Even hunting and fishing gear.
Cool.
All kinds of apparel for all kinds of sports.
Great selection. Come over here. I've got some other things.
Plus, a helpful staff.
I wish my husband was as helpful.
And everyday low prices mean you never wait for a sale.
Prices like these, I may never leave.
Great.
The Sports Authority. You've never seen anything quite like it.
Ah, yes, golf course architect extraordinaire. I'm not saying that because he's heavy. I'm saying it because he's my brother.
I see he's the better looking one of the family, isn't it?
Yeah, and he's also older than I am. Actually, Craig on hand doing some reconstruction work at Oak Hill Country Club, which will be the site of the 1995 Ryder Cup here in Rochester, New York. So we wanted to bring him by and have him watch a championship round.
Bryan Goebel needs to ride in for a strike right here. Got it right. Oh! A solid 10. Yeah, the guy right with speed. That's the first real rap that, well, he left a 10-pin on the left lane. Big shot right there.
Excellent shot. Execution was there.
Well, if he struck there in the next one, he knocked it down to one pin. It keeps the lead at right around 20, 22 with the conversion.
Well, we were on the subject of golf, talking about the Ryder Cup, but don't forget, coming up, a PGA Tour championship from one of the outstanding golf courses in the United States, the Olympic Club, out in San Francisco. Boy, I'd like to go play that golf course.
You've
again.
You've played it before,
oh,
right?
Several times. Just a terrific golf course.
You used to play that with Harry Golden,
mm-hmm.
Didn't you? Yeah. Goebel, the seventh frame, needs to get back on the strike track. Oh, two ringing tens in a row. You know, Brian said that he's been going about his business on the television telecast and everything, and his opponents have been making a mistake somewhere along the line. This time it appears that he's made the mistake.
Well, when you've got numero uno, top gunslinger in town, and you give him an opening, you've got problems.
Two 10-pins, Oden, as Marcel looks on. Marcel Frontier, the owner of Marcel's Olympic Bowl, outstanding figure in Rochester, in the bowling community, and in the community at large.
Up and at him. I will be interested, if he gets by this game, to see if he doesn't change the angle and the approach to this pair of lanes just a little bit.
I don't think so, because right now what he's trying to do, he's going straight at it, but he knows if he leaks it right, it's going to hook back flush. It doesn't go high for him.
Good
anything,
point.
If anything, that's what will happen. He knows he can just throw every ball in the pocket from where he's at.
Straight with just a touch of backup to the 10 pin.
Well, the difference, 22 pins, three frames to go. Duke has got him, but we'll find out. Player of the year could hang in the balance here in the last three frames. Sure is getting that hit, isn't he?
Content to play up and at him. Beautiful strike there in the eighth. Still has room for 258.
And what's Goebel going to run for? 236?
Mm-hmm.
It's got to start right here, Denny. Can't afford any more 10 pins.
A little deeper with the feet. Oh, perfect shot there.
Perfect shot.
Yep. Well, he'd like to have had that back the last trip on 34.
Yeah, but even though he'd like to have it back, I mean, he couldn't have thrown any better than he threw that one back in the sixth frame. There's the score. Difference 22 pins. Both players on strike. Ninth frame, Bryan Goebel has to strike right now. Absolute must. His worst shot of the game. Just soft. He didn't keep the speed up then. Mm-hmm. Maybe the pressure of the moment got to him.
You could see him the moment he turned around from the foul line. He knew that it's not what he was after.
No, that was his good lane, too. Absolutely his good lane.
I think it's the first time that we've seen him go high on 33 the entire telecast.
It just was a soft speed.
Mm-hmm. So instead of the foundation strike in the ninth, an eighth spare for Bryan Goebel. As I mentioned when we took a look at the top 24, the newly elected president of the PBA, Walter A. Williams Jr., will take over at the beginning of January and serve a two-year term. We wish him all the best of luck.
He'll replace Mike Albee, who's done an outstanding job.
And Messenger.
Nope.
Oh, come on, Mike.
It was a fast rack, but it got it
fast.
Oh, and it fell off, but it doesn't count. They'll set it back up.
But well, what's the ruling?
The ruling is if the machine hits it, it goes back up.
I know.
Watch it now. There's supposed to be a three-second time delay here, and I don't think there was 3 seconds there.
That would have been a double and a 32-pin lead heading into the 10th frame had it been a strike.
And it would have locked the game up. As it is now, he still needs a mark to lock it up. If he should open it, any kind of open, miss a spare or anything, Goebel could strike out and still either tie or win this match. Needs to make it then. If he misses, he finishes at 216. That's the best Goebel can get, so he's got to make it. Nothing but 10 pins the whole game. Strikes are 10 pins.
So he's comfortable with shooting those.
Left five of them.
That's what I said. What about changing angles?
He's winning.
You mean he just won?
He's won.
All right. He played it conservative. Does he change that philosophy against Doug Kent, a guy who averaged 240-something throughout the entire week?
He will experiment on this fill ball, I think. He'll give this fill ball, I think, a little more room and see if it hooks back flush.
Then he has, Mike. I mean, didn't throw one flush strike.
But he bowled 227 with 5 10-pins. The next game with those 5 10-pins carry, he's got them all, then. I mean,
okay. If they carry, but I think that's the big question. Bryan Goebel, a very successful week, although you can see the disappointment written all over his face. He was trying to win back-to-back out here. That hasn't been done since last year when Walter Ray won a couple in a row.
Just, you know, the key shots, I think, were back in the 6th and 7th frames. He left hard 10s both times. He did not take advantage of an opportunity in the 9th frame.
All right, Bryan Goebel finishes 3rd. Norm Duke inches up the ladder. And he is looking squarely at title number 5 in 1994. Standing in his way, the top seed, Doug.
Just one more strike for a 300 game.
The inside track on your favorite bowlers become part of the PBA fan club.
All fan club members receive the PBA media guide and club programs along with your official membership card. Also, for a limited time only, this Millionaire's Club poster is included.
So don't wait. Call today. Call 1-800-299-4-PBA for your membership in the PBA fan club.
Science is best done in an interactive environment. You have to have this incredible curiosity. You have to figure out how it works. You're not learning something that someone else has written down. You get to discover that. And the best time for a scientist, when you get a result that is exactly the opposite of what you thought was going to happen. Because in that brief moment of time, the whole world changes.
Glaxo, on the brink of discovery.
It's everybody working together that's going to beat the disease.
Sports fans, you've seen the best. Now, Marv Albert's here to show you the rest.
Lots of horsing around in the world of sports.
There's 45 minutes of non-stop fun in Marv's great new video, the hilarious Albert Achievement Award. And best of all, your video's free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated. In this great new video, Marv catches all the amazing footwork, agility, grace, and power
that makes sports so much fun to watch.
Hysterical!
Call now, and you'll also get your choice of an authentic NFL Pro-Line hat. Free! Pick your favorite team. It's up to you. The Albert Achievement Awards video and the NFL hat of your choice make a great gift for yourself or your favorite sports fan. And it comes with 54 issues of Sports Illustrated for only $1.47 an issue. You save over 50% off the cover price. For quicker delivery, use your credit card. Nobody's into sports like Sports Illustrated. Get into it.
Is it? Welcome back for our championship frame here in the Greater Rochester Open. Match number one, Tommy Baker looking for a strike.
Needed a strike to win, Dan. Behind the whole match, had the opportunity right here. Really didn't throw it like he wanted to. Hooks too quickly, through the heart of the pins, and it's a victory for Bryan Goebel, a disappointment for Tom Baker.
209 to 200, Bryan Goebel advanced on to game number two. And it was Bryan with a trip of the four in the seventh frame.
Yeah, this made six in a row. Pete Weber could never strike on the left lane, or just not very many of them. Goebel put it together this game. Got a nice break right here. Four pin goes out, six in a row. Goebel has victory. Pete Weber still looking for that victory this year.
248 to 204, then it was on to the semifinal match, and instead of a strike in the 10th frame, it was a spare that was needed.
If he'd have missed it, Goebel could have struck out and tied the match, but Norm Duke is not a candidate for player of the year for nothing. Making the 10 pin, he says, no problem.
Easy does it on the 10. He shot five of them in the semifinal match, five for five, winning comfortably 227 to 201. Well, Norm is smiling right there because he's in the title match. He is seriously looking for title number five in 1994 to wrap up perhaps player of the year honors. But the gentleman on the right, well, he would be the player of the year in Rochester, which is where his hometown fans are ready to cheer him on.
Polaroid asked me Sinbad needs supermodels to demonstrate the sleek, stylish Captiva camera. It holds the pictures inside the camera's special pocket, so you take them out and put them in your pocket. My pocket. The Polaroid Captiva.
Kellogg's Raisin Bran tastes so good, people forget it's nutritious. Why do you eat it?
Nutrition.
Good.
I'm a health nut.
Wheat bran. I love it.
Wait a minute. Is this true?
10% more raisins? Free.
Wow, more raisins?
We're talking about nutrition.
Free raisins? Ooh, la la.
That's not important.
Yes, it is. Now Kellogg's Raisin Bran has 10% more raisins. Absolutely free.
Forget what it says behind my hand.
10% more raisins.
Free!
Right now during Sears Days, all Craftsman hand tools and all power tools are on sale. All paint, every gallon, every brand is on sale. And there's a lot more. The Sears Days sale, bringing America's best to you.
Arrow, the maker of the world-famous T50 staple gun tacker, introduces The Brute. A complete line of heavy-duty tape measures with non-slip hook, contoured design with easy-to-work lock. For the professional and the do-it-yourselfer, Arrow measures up.
With Minwax polyurethane, you can do more than admire your wood. You can live with it, too, because Minwax contains pure urethane oil to protect wood while giving it beauty you can really live with. Minwax keeps wood beautiful.
Science is best done in an interactive environment. You have to have this incredible curiosity, and you have to figure out how it works. You're not learning something that someone else has written down. You get to discover that. And the best time for a scientist is when you get a result that is exactly the opposite of what you thought was going to happen. Because in that brief moment of time, the whole world changes.
Glaxo, on the brink of discovery.
It's everybody working together that's going to beat the disease.
Unique, specialized trophy to the winner of this year's Greater Rochester Open. Only two remain. Doug Kent, the hometown favorite, and Norm Duke. If he opens with a strike, they'll lift the ceiling right off this place.
He switched balls here, Dan, and this ball reacted very well for him in his practice shots.
The way
oh, the 7 pin went over late, leaving only the 2-8. Much easier spare than the 2-7-8. He's going to shoot this probably off the... Well, I don't know. We've got to find out whether the machine hit it or not. As far as it... I guess it didn't. Just a 2-8. He said, you know, he was just too pumped up on that shot. He knows it. Now he's got to make this spare, get himself under control.
He is wearing a microphone, so we'll try and listen in from time to time. Excellent spare there.
At least it gets the jitters out of the way a little bit. It gets a bad shot out of there. See how he plays it off the strike lane and away, but really right of it, throwing it out to the hook area and coming back to the spare. Norm Duke.
I think Norm is questioning whether or not the seven pin was hit, do you think?
Yes, I think it's exactly what he's questioning. I think he thinks the machine hit the seven pin. I really couldn't tell, Dan. I didn't notice that it fell over, but that machine comes down in a hurry.
Well, perhaps the boys in the truck will give us an opportunity, perhaps, to look back. And I'm told now that we will get an opportunity to see that.
Here's the shot. Comes in light. Norm Duke's coming over to watch this now. The seven pin's up there. Pin's rolling around. The seven pin's rocking. It looked to me like it fell before the machine hit it.
You'd almost have to have a camera behind the lane to have seen that one.
Boy, they've got the 2-7 up on the left lane. 2-7-8 up on the left lane. I don't know why they've got that sitting there.
I think it was up just in case they were going to go ahead and have Doug Kent shoot it. Now,
oh, it's exactly right. Out. That's right, man. Yeah, exactly. Well, they were ahead of thinking back there, aren't they? I'll tell you what. Now Duke's got to refocus that. He gets his mind on his game.
Very fortunate shot there. Ball went long, long, long.
Now, Danny, I disagree with you. Dick Weber bowled for 40 years, back 50 years, striking like that all the time. It's just a traditional wall shot. With these reactive resin balls and the basically the double voided pins, I mean, that's an automatic hit almost. Now, 30 years ago with solid pins and everything, you'd have had a 4-5-7, but not now.
All right.
Straight is great.
Okay, I'm going to go along with it.
Right.
And I'm gonna adjust
your thinking.
My opinion and my thinking.
You're right. Oh boy. See, what he wanted to do in this match was be aggressive and get out quick, and it's not happening. Knees bent to start with, a little flex right there. Ball's over in front of the right shoulder. Controlled swing all the way through. Nice position right here. Knees bent again. Real low at the foul line. Powerful shot.
I had a chance to talk to Doug last night and ask him, is it an advantage or disadvantage bowling at home?
I think it's going to be an advantage. I really do. They've been great all week. And tonight, I think they're going to pull me through tonight.
Well, he's behind right now by 11. He's got to get start putting some X's on the board. Some pressure on Mr. Duke.
And that's a start.
That's a start, exactly.
That will loosen things up a little bit, although Tracy right now, I think just a touch nervous.
I don't know, either that or not much expression there, was there?
Well, Hubby's behind by 11. Let's see what Norm Duke does on the right-hand lane. Now, my question is, that shot was 100% better. That shot was a flush strike.
But they're X's on the scoreboard,
Danny. Don't start with me.
They're all X's.
Okay.
They're all part of striking and making a living on the PBA Tour. You don't just flush every shot. You got to be able to carry the wall shot, the trip fours, all of them. Ask Harry. He's right next to you.
Let's see. What's scary is I remember carrying wall shots. That hasn't happened for 15, 20 years on this tour.
Well, Duke is very versatile.
Solid 10. Good shot there on 33.
Guarantee you, he'd rather have a wall shot there than that solid 10.
Well, anybody knows that.
Okay.
Would he like to have a 4-5-7?
He's not going to leave a 4-5-7. Although he did say this week he left his first 8-10 all year.
See?
So.
My point.
So he leaves one 8-10 in 42 games. He can win the tournament right now.
I hear you. I wouldn't disagree with anything he's done this year.
His 6-10 pin in a game and a half. He's made them all. Thrown every ball in the pocket. Hasn't missed the pocket. Doug Kent now has got to strike twice to get back into this match. He wants the microphone off or something, or it fell out of his back pocket.
Quick-handed Kevin Shippey. All right. Power pack in place.
A little distracting. It would be. Well, he made that choice, though, when he decided to put the microphone on.
Sure.
So, I mean, that goes with the territory. He's got to just put it out of his mind and concentrate on making the best shot he can right now. A lot of power.
Ooh, rolled out, diced him up. There's his parents.
Oh, he liked that one. And Mom is applauding the effort as well. This ball rolled out right at the pocket, but he was doing this all week long. See how far left and how far right the ball goes? Then it rolls, it just rolls out there, but still dices the five.
I'll tell you what's staggering. Right now, in one shot, Doug's probably throwing more hook than Norm has in four.
But Norm's still ahead.
That's right.
Talking to himself.
One more time, he said. Got it into the oil early, and that's disaster.
Jesus. See, that's why Norm Duke is not throwing the big hook right there, Denny. Got it in there left on the left lane, which is tighter. And it's just the 2-8-10, almost an impossible split. He'll throw hard at the 2-8 and hope something bounces around. It doesn't happen very often. Eight out. Duke's going to step up and jump right on that.
The price you pay for circling the ball at times, 2-8-10.
First one we've seen tonight.
That's right. Little softer speed. Beautiful shot for Norm Duke with a strike. And I asked him, what about PBA Player of the Year?
If that's good enough and the voters feel that I am the best this year, then so be it, and thank you. If not, then there's not really a whole lot I can do about it. Yes, I think about it daily. Yes, I was watching tonight when Walter barely fell out of the finals, and yes, I'll be watching next week. I'm sure he's watching me. That's part of it. But it cannot be a distraction for me, otherwise then that's when it's going to affect my play.
Pretty well said, I thought.
Another look at some of the numbers. In average, that's something that's obviously very closely scrutinized. Walter Ray again, 223.11.
In the wins and losses in the match play, Walter Ray leading in a lot of categories.
The one point that I made, and you and I talked about this, Mike, just prior to the telecast. If Norm wins tonight, that's five titles. Walter Ray has two. Yes, I know he leads in several other categories, but isn't the goal each and every week to win the tournament?
Of course, the goal is to win the tournament. If Norm wins tonight, that's five victories, and I feel it solidifies his hold on. Nobody can catch him with victories in. Oh, solid eight. Boy, oh boy. Down 27 pins. Still could win the match. It's not likely, but he still could. If he picks this up and strikes out, he can finish with 232, and that's the way he's got to be thinking. He likes the right lane. Make the spare. Come back and set it up with a strike on your more difficult lane, lane 33, and then just hope Duke doesn't run away from it.
Doug Kent, third time he's led a PBA event, 0-for-2 from the top spot. Was hoping to change all that in familiar surroundings here tonight in Rochester.
Really hasn't performed real well at this point in time. Doesn't mean he can't do it the last part of this game, but he hasn't yet.
Must strike, and does.
just got to be thinking, I got to take it out the sheet, you know, and hope Duke doesn't bowl more than 232. We know Duke is not going to miss a pocket there. He's just not going to miss the pocket.
No. Not going to give anything away, and I don't blame him. Don't forget, coming up Saturday on ESPN, Florida Gators look to get back on track as they take on the Georgia Bulldogs. Eric Zier, one of the Heisman Trophy candidates, he'll put it up in the air. Number 5, Florida against Georgia. That one starts at 7 o'clock.
Florida's what, 17-point favorite, maybe, or something like that.
For the double.
And another temp in. That keeps Kent in the match. That really does keep Doug Kent in the match right now. Gives him some semblance of hope. Two intense faces right there. It's harder on the parents. It's harder on her. He's been through the wars. Right. He goes through all the games. He's got the ball in his hand. Oh. Wow. First mistake. Kind of reared up at that foul line. This is a real chance right now for Doug Kent, and he knows it. He's got to jump on this. As we see it, ball just fall off. He lost his balance just slightly, missed the 10 pin.
For the double.
Solid 10.
Wow.
Wow. Oh, man. He really gave this one room, Dan. This was the shot he was playing all week long. Circle it out, roll it out at the pocket, and carry 10, but the 6-pin didn't cooperate. Went right around the 10-pin.
Just can't throw it any better than that in a clutch situation.
He can still shoot 212. If you can strike here in the ninth and take it out. Norm Duke is only going at 207 pace right now after that missed 10 pin. The difference, 15 pins, two frames to go. Player of the year may hang in the balance. What can he do? I mean, he goes then in the sixth frame, solid 8, solid strike, solid 10, solid 10. And he's trying to win his first title against the best bowler in the country this year.
Averaged 260 last night. An incredible week. Averaged 246 on this pair of lanes. And all you're thinking to yourself is, give me one game where I make some good shots. Let me carry. Let me win my first title. And nothing but frustration for Doug Kent and his fans.
He made two bad shots in this game, the first frame and the fifth frame.
To fill two frames and knows it. Sometimes fate is the toughest opponent you'll ever match up against.
You know, Duke's sitting on the bench. He can do nothing about what Kent does. He can't make that 10-pin stand up, you know, but it did twice in a row. If he strikes two times there, it's a different match. He's in the lead going into the 10th.
Norm hit a hurdle in the 8th, missed the 10-pin, opened the door, and a couple of 10-pins back-to-back slammed it shut for Doug Kent.
For the win, and knocks the 10-pin out of there. That's it. Doug Kent 0 for 3 now in the top spot.
Very professional performance by Mr. Duke.
Except for the missed barrel. There's
exactly.
only chink in the armor, yeah.
Made one little mistake, and Doug was not able to overcome that.
In fact, he only left one other pin other than the 10-pin or a strike in two games. Another solid 10. He's going to finish. We wouldn't have thought 216 would win the title.
Well, I tell you, Norm knows from the bottom of his heart how disappointed Doug Kent really is at this moment. Fans, very appreciative. A nice round of applause for Norm Duke, title number 5 here in 1994.
Title number 9 overall, too, Dan.
All right, Norm Duke disposes of the 10-pin, shoots 216, and wins the Greater Rochester Open and may have locked up Player of the Year honors in the process. All right, when we come back to Rochester, we'll chat with Norm Duke and ask him about strategy on the championship round pair.
Ask had to be you. It invented the standards for how a minivan should ride and drive. It exceeds 1998 car safety standards. It gives you more choices than any other minivan. Dodge Caravan, the best-selling minivan of all time. Millions of people wouldn't know what to do without it, but they sure know what to do with it.
It had to be you. I wanted to be you. It had to be you.
I want a 95 Corolla.
We can make it happen. We can make it happen.
The 95 Corollas are here and better than ever, with savings up to $700 on the car designed to be the best in its class. Get your best deal now.
We can make it happen.
Get Corolla quality, Toyota dependability, and lower payments with a special Toyota lease. We can make it happen now.
A 95 Corolla? I don't believe this. It's exactly what I wanted.
You have seen the masters of the game. And what have you learned? Stockton's Secret of the Green. Colbert's Path Out of the Trap. Trevino's Answer to the Blue. Albus's Way Through the Chasm. And the Labyrinth of Your Mind. Remember, we all want the lesson. That's why we watch the Ka'anapali Classic. Let ESPN show us the way. Beginning Friday afternoon, live at 3 Eastern.
The championship round finals of the Rochester Open are being brought to you by AMF Bowling, makers of the new King Cobra ball with Strike R resin. All right, Norm Duke, title number 5, and Joanne Fournier has a beautiful trophy for you.
Congratulations on your great bowl. The fans in Rochester love you. You can hear it all day long.
I appreciate it. Thank you, Marcel Fournier, for bringing us here to Rochester again. I think this is, 10 or 11 years straight?
That's our 10th straight. It'll be 11 next time. So we're looking forward to a great next year. But congratulations on this win. Number 6 this year, right?
Number 5.
I apologize. Number 5, maybe 6 next week. But congrats, and there's a big check for you.
Thank you. I would, I'd first like to say hi to my wife. She's at home. I know she's very, very nervous. Hello, Karen. I love you. Secondly, I'd like to really a sincere appreciation for Bill Hall. He's taken me from when I was really having problems with my foot and just really stayed behind me, and I appreciate it, Bill. Thanks.
You said you were pumped up for this one, title number 5. I know there's 2 weeks left, but Mike and I both feel like you've really solidified that Player of the Year.
Well, I don't count anything out. Walter Ray Williams can win anytime he wants. And Bryan Goebel also, he's showing that he's up there in that group. So I'm just going to take it a tournament of time and do my best.
Norm, everybody else hooking the ball so much tonight, you decided to go with a straight shot. It was the best strategy, obviously.
Yeah, I needed to hook it a little more than that 10-pin, though.
What happened on that 10-pin?
I was thinking about what I had to do to get the 10-pin out, and I missed it then, and I thought, well, that's not going to get it.
I know you, too, also have to feel for Doug Kent. You know what it's like to lead a tournament, bowl fantastic, and not win.
Yeah, really, especially when you haven't had a title out here yet. And hats off to him, and he's going to win a number of titles.
All right, we'll say goodbye, and maybe title number 6 next week in Grand Rapids. You never know. Norm Duke leading the way for Player of the Year. Week, the PBA Tour will make its home in Grand Rapids, Michigan, with the championship round finals of the Great Lakes Classic being staged at the Welsh Auditorium beginning at 7:30 Eastern Time Wednesday, November 2nd, live on ESPN. And coming up next on ESPN, Top Rank Boxing featuring a USBA welterweight championship fight. Join Al Bernstein and Joel Myers for all the action in that one.